Okay. For my next showdown with that 70s show, I'm going to do it on Jeopardy for the week. And it'll be between Eric Foreman, Michael Kelso, and Fez.
Welcome to Jeopardy, everyone.
Thank you, Trebek. Let's do this, and as I honor the life and legacy of Alex Trebek. Here we go. Let's do this.
This is Jeopardy!
That 70s show edition.
And?
Good luck, boys. Here we go.
Clues are worth two.
Categories for the Jeopardy round are.
In these categories. Grammy winners.
Grammy winners.
Historic women.
Historic women.
Food words
and phrases.
Literary characters.
Literary characters.
Zoology.
Zoology.
And I want
to be.
Layer one.
All right.
Make a selection,
what do you,
please.
Where do we go, Eric?
While pointing the Wii remote at the screen.
Let's start with I want to be for.
Select the clue.
200. I want to be for 200. Okay.
One of these dancers, so I'm practicing my arabesques and pirouettes so I can perform with the Kirov.
Eric?
Okay.
What is a ballerina?
Use the Wii remote or press the corresponding direct.
Yeah.
Correct. Go again, Eric.
Select again.
Want to be for four.
One of these, from the Greek for star sailor, like John Glenn or Buzz Aldrin.
Fez?
Let's hear it, player three.
What is an astronaut? That's it. Go again, Fez. 600, please, on I Want to Be.
One of these, and deal with the health problems of Vicunas, Pintos, and Great Danes. Yes,
Kelso?
Player two.
What is a veterinarian? Yes. Go again, Michael. Michael Kelso.
Go again, player two.
Want to be for eight.
Like Martin Luther King and the Dalai Lama, and be honored with this humanitarian prize given in Oslo.
Eric.
Player one.
What is the Nobel Peace Prize? Yeah, hey, you're right. Go again, Eric Foreman.
Please pick again.
Want to be for 1,000.
This, from the Greek for straight, and make some big bucks correcting crooked teeth with braces. Okay, layer
Eric.
One.
What's an orthodontist?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Layer one.
Let's
you
do.
Again, please.
Let's do Grammy winners for 200. Okay, Grammy winners 200.
'78, just the way you are.
Eric.
Layer one.
Who's Billy Joel?
Yes.
That's right.
We return to you.
Grammy winners for 400.
1966, Strangers in the Night.
Michael Kelso. Who is Frank Sinatra? Yes.
Correct.
Go again, Michael.
You
Kelso.
Get to pick again. Layer two.
Grammy winners 600.
1992, Tears in Heaven.
Fez.
It's player three.
Who's Eric Clapton? Yes, that's right. 800, please, on Grammy winners.
1995, Kiss from a Rose.
Eric?
Yes, player one.
Who's Seal? Right. Go again, Eric.
Player one. Back
Grammy winners for 1,000.
1973, Killing Me Softly with His Song.
Eric?
Player one.
Who is Roberta Flack?
That is
you are right.
Please pick again, player one.
How about we do literary characters for 200?
In A Christmas Carol, the ghost of this dead partner is the first spirit to visit Scrooge. Okay.
Fez. What is who is Marley? Who's Jacob Marley? Say either way, you're right. Go ahead, Fez. Go again.
Player three, back to you.
Literary characters four.
In A Scandal in Bohemia and other early stories, Sir Arthur Conan Doyle gave this physician a wife, Mary Morstan.
Michael Kelso.
Let's hear it. Player two.
Who's Dr. Watson? Correct.
You get
please.
To pick again, player two.
Literary characters.
And here's Kelly.
John Tenniel depicted this Lewis Carroll title character in 1865.
Michael.
It's player two.
Kelso. Who's Alice? You got it.
Back to you.
Literary characters eight.
Selection. The invaders in this H.G. Wells novel are described as having tentacles and a peculiar V-shaped mouth.
Eric.
Yes, player one.
What is War of the Worlds? Yeah. Correct. Go again.
Player one.
Thousand Please on literary characters.
Ivan Petrovich Voynitsky is the title character of this 1899 Chekhov play.
Eric.
Let's hear it, player one.
What is Uncle Vanya? Yes.
Player one.
Why don't we do zoology for 200? Okay, zoology for 200.
The giant Pacific this may have as many as 1,600 suckers on its arms. They help it to taste and touch. Okay,
Eric.
One.
What's an octopus? Correct. Go again, Eric Foreman.
We return to you.
400, please, on zoology.
While it doesn't breathe fire, the dragon named for this Indonesian island does kill its prey with its deadly saliva.
Fez.
Player three.
What's a Komodo?
Right.
That's right.
You again, player three.
Zoology for four. Zoology for 600, please.
Doggone it, a mud puppy isn't a little doggy, but a large one of these amphibians.
Michael Kelso?
Here too.
What's a salamander? You are right.
Select again.
Zoology for eight.
A type of this snake that sounds like a James Clavell novel is Australia's deadliest and most feared.
Fez.
Yes, player three.
What's a taipan? You are right.
That's right. Way to go.
Go again, Fez. How
choose
about
again, player three.
Zoology for 1,000.
The rare white alligator has a condition called leucism, meaning it lacks this skin pigment.
Michael?
It's player two.
What is melanin?
That's
you are correct. Go again, Michael Kelso.
Player two. Pick again.
I said four in that last category. Sorry about that. Can we do historic women for 200? Okay.
This Secretary of State, whose first name is from a musical term, had originally planned to be a concert pianist.
Fez?
Let's hear it, player three.
What? Who is Condoleezza Rice? That's it. Go again, Fez.
You again, player three.
Mr. Oakerman for four.
Shortly after her disappearance, her publisher, husband George Putnam, released Last Flight, containing her diaries.
Michael?
Yes, player two.
Who's Amelia Earhart? That's it.
Please pick again.
Historic woman for 600, please.
The Moses of her people. She helped hundreds of slaves escape along the Underground Railroad. Player one.
Eric? Who's Harriet Tubman? You are correct.
Choose again, player one.
Stork woman for 800, please.
She met her beloved teacher, Ann Sullivan, in 1887. Okay, player
Eric?
One.
Who's Helen Keller? Yes.
Player one.
Stork woman for a grand.
This first American woman in space heads a company geared to girls who are interested in science and math. Yes,
Eric?
Player one.
Who's Sally Ride?
Good for
there
you.
There you go. It's your board.
Player one, back to you for our next selection.
Do food words and phrases for 200. Okay, food words and phrases for 200.
Breakfast dish that can also mean to flatten.
Fez?
It's player three.
What's a pancake?
Good.
Right. Okay.
Select again.
400.
In 1966, the U.S. government banned M-80s and these round red firecrackers.
Kelso?
Let's hear it.
Michael
two.
Kelso? What are cherry bombs? Yes. Nice.
Player two, back to you.
Food word six.
Used before barrel, it suggests the homespun style and philosophy of rural folk.
Eric.
Okay, layer one.
What's a cracker barrel? Right. Let's go 1,000.
You get to pick again, layer one. Here's Kelly to start us off.
A nursery rhyme says, this person, mend my shoe. Get it done by 2:30.
Eric.
Layer one.
What's a cobbler? All right, the last clue is all Eric's because it's the daily double.
And we'll wrap up the board with this clue.
Yep, I knew it.
It's the daily double. You are.
I'll bet it all. Okay, Eric's gonna bet it all. Okay.
All right, here's your clue. It's the spicy two-word name for a type of knot that lets you join a rope to a rail or a post.
What's a clove hitch? And you
that
are right.
You even further ahead.
And that means that Fez will get to go first in Double Jeopardy.
Going first in the Double Jeopardy round when we return. Clues are worth $400 to $3,000.
Here are the Double Jeopardy rounds categories.
It all adds
up.
Related words.
Related words.
How about a little romance,
language?
Book titles. Completes the Star
Trek title.
And the scintillating
1700s.
All right, if you're ready, it's Double Jeopardy time.
All right, where do we start, Fez? Scintillating 1700s for 400.
The future King George II lost his marbles over Henrietta Howard and gave her Marble Hill House on this river.
Michael?
Let's hear it. Player two.
What is Thames? Yes.
Right you are.
Go again.
We return to you, player
1712.
In 1752, suave seducer Sergei Saltykov spiced up the life of this future empress.
Hello, son.
Michael?
Player two.
Who's Catherine the Great?
Select again.
800, please. On scintillating 1700s.
A famous one of these, Marie Camargo, is remembered for shortening her skirts to half length.
Best.
It's player three.
Was it ballerina? Hey, you're right. Go again, Fez.
Please pick again, player three.
Let's do 1600.
Born into a family of actors, he was expelled from a seminary, big surprise, before finding fame as a lusty libertine.
Michael
okay,
Kelso.
Player two.
Who's Giovanni Casanova?
That's
correct.
Player two. You pick
go
again,
again,
please.
Kelso. What we do, finish up the 1700s for 2000. Okay.
Kelly will present this clue.
An engraving of this 18th century French monarch, America's most powerful ally during the Revolution, hangs at Mount Vernon.
Michael?
Yes, player two.
Who is Louis the 16th? No.
Anyone else?
Fez or Eric?
Guess on this?
Fez.
Player three.
Who is Louis the 14th? Or 16th.
That
is correct.
Player three. Back to you.
Where do we go, Fez?
Selection.
Related words. For 400, please.
A park was originally an enclosed place. This related word still means an enclosure for racehorses.
Fez.
Okay, player three.
What is a stall? And no, that wouldn't be right.
Anyone else? Let's
Kelso?
Hear it. Player two.
What's paddock?
You
got
it.
Where we go, Michael
you
Kelso?
Get to pick again, player two.
Related words for eight.
Culprit, meaning the guilty party, evolved from this adjective meaning guilty.
Fez.
Yes, player three.
What is culpable? Got it.
Player three. Pick
can I have related words for 1200?
Fabricate is related to this verb that can mean to write something fraudulent, like a signature.
Fez.
It's player three.
What is forge?
Yeah.
Right.
You again, player.
Related word 16.
As score can mean to cut, it makes sense that it's from the same root as this word for big scissors.
Kelso.
Yes, player two.
What's forge? Oh, no, excuse me. What is shear? What is shears? Say it either way, shears is correct. Again, Kelso.
Player two, back to you.
Michael Kelso. Related words for 2000.
To do this to something is to make it holy. A word from the same root. Okay, player one.
What is hello?
That's
correct.
It. We return to you, player one.
All adds up for 400.
It's 7 plus 7 plus 7 plus 7 plus 8.
Eric.
Player 1.
What is 36? Correct.
Yep.
Again.
Choose again.
Adds up for eight.
3 plus 53 plus 100 plus 153 equals this.
Fez.
It's player three.
Where's 3009? That's it. Go again, Fez.
Player three.
How about adds up to 12?
1,012 plus 255 plus 11 equals this.
Mike and Kelso.
Player two.
What is this? 1,278. Got it. Go again, Mr. Kelso.
Choose again. Player.
All adds up for 16.
144 plus 244 plus 344 equals this. It's
Michael.
Player one.
What is 732? Got it! Go again.
Select again.
About, adds up for 2,000.
1,144 plus 1,793 equals this.
Fez.
Player three.
What is 2,937? Correct! Go again. Fez.
Player three.
How about we do, how about a little romance language for 200? I mean, 400, excuse me. A little romance language for 200, okay.
Around the Vatican, you might be able to practice this source language of all romance languages.
Michael Kelso.
Okay. Player two.
What is Latin? Yes.
Please pick again.
In her, please.
Two. Of Catalan, Bulgarian, or Romanian, the one that is not a Romance language.
Fez.
Let's hear it, player three.
What is Bulgarian?
That
you
is
got it.
Player three, back to you.
Romance language 12.
It's the most widely spoken Romance language in the world.
Fez.
Yes, player three.
What's Spanish? Right. About 1,600 on Romance language.
Ligurian, Lombard, and Piedmontese are all dialects of this Romance language.
Michael Kelso.
Player two.
What's Italian? Correct. Go again, Mr. Kelso.
We return to you.
Romance language 2,000.
This extinct Romance language of Croatia shares its name with a dog breed.
No idea.
Here's
it was.
Dalmatian.
Dalmatian. That was confusing.
You again, player two.
Completes the Star Trek title. For 400.
Where no man has done this.
Michael
it's
Kelso?
Player two.
What's gone before? Yes!
Good for you.
How about 800 on
you get to
Star
pick
Trek
again,
title?
Player
the
two. Trouble with these creatures. Okay,
Michael?
Player two.
What are tribbles? Right! Pick again.
You again, player
1,200,
two.
Please.
Muds these. Yes, player
Michael
two.
Michael Kelso? What are spores?
Sorry.
No!
Anyone
Eric or Fez?
Trying to come up with the correct response?
Fez.
Let's hear it, player three.
What is... What are moons? Oh, no.
Any
Eric, do you want to try? Yes,
yes,
Eric?
Player one.
What are women? There you go.
Layer one.
Star Trek title for 1,600.
The city on the edge of this.
Eric.
Okay. Layer one.
What's forever? Where's the? Oh, I didn't mean nowhere.
That's.
Anyone
else care to try to come up with a correct response?
You accidentally said nowhere. Sorry about that. Michael
Let's
Kelso.
Hear it. Player two.
What's forever?
you're right.
Go again.
Layer 2.
2000 on Star Trek title. Oh, daily double. Oh boy.
The first of the daily doubles. You're in second place, so what is your wager going to be? You need to select your wager.
2000.
Answer. The Corbomite, this.
What is syndrome? Oh, so no.
Here's the response.
The answer was...
Maneuver.
Maneuver.
Layer 2. You
How about
again,
we do
please.
Book titles for 400? Titles for 400.
Hemingway got the title for this 1926 novel from Ecclesiastes.
Bez.
It's player 3.
What is Farewell to Arms? No! That can't be it.
Anyone else?
Michael or Eric?
Player
Kelso.
Two.
Oh boy. What is what is to have and have not? No.
Sorry.
That's not it either.
Anyone else?
Eric, you want to try it?
Yes on this?
Eric?
It's player one.
What is the sun also rises? Eric, you got it. Good. Yes.
Choose again, player one.
Book title's 8.
Dickens, let's see. Martin Sweetledoo? No. Martin Sweetleback? No, I've got it. Martin this.
Bez.
Yes, player 3.
What is Chuzzlewit? Hey, you got it. Pick again.
Player 3. Back
1200, please, on book titles.
Shakespeare's Sonnet 30 says... I summon up this, which became the title of a Proust work.
Michael?
Okay, layer 2.
What is Remembrance of Things Past? Very good! 1600, please.
We return to... Faulkner was using Dark House as a novel title, but there was something about the light in this month.
Eric?
Layer 1?
What's August?
Yes.
You are right! And now the last clue is all Eric's, because it's the daily double.
And the last clue for $2,000. Answer, the second daily double. And you have the lead. Give us a wager, player one.
Let's go 400. There you go.
Here is your daily double clue. James Jones considered Old Soldiers Never Die as a title for his World War II novel, but settled on this. From a Kipling line.
What is From Here to Eternity? Right you are, Mr. Foreman. It looks like all three of you will be around for Final Jeopardy.
All of you will continue on to play Final Jeopardy when we return. Here's
Final Jeopardy category is as follows.
Landmarks. What are you going to wait?
Place your bets, guys.
Each direction on the plus control pad represents a different response. Press a direction to select an answer. And the clue reads, the landmark site known to the Lakota as Six Grandfathers was renamed this after a prominent lawyer.
How did everyone do? Let's see.
What did you put as your response?
It looks like Michael Kelso put down Mount Rushmore. And that is correct. And his wager was $3,800, so he's going to finish the game with $15,000. Putting him in second place. Mount Rushmore is what Fez came up with as well. And we're going to add to his $11,200. Looks like $800, so he's going to finish this showdown with $12,000.
Let's see your response.
See what Michael's, see what Eric said. He also said Mount Rushmore.
With that response,
how much did you wager? $9,000, so he's going to finish with $35,000, and that makes Eric remain champ.
You've come out ahead as our champion, player one.
Well done. I'll see you for the next gameplay, everyone.
So long.